All right, so we're back in again, and we're going to attack it, I think, the way that you attacked the previous ones, where we're going to ask kind of systematically, is the VC dimension greater than or equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, by giving examples until we just can't anymore. So, good. So, is the VC greater than or equal to 1?
Yes.
Yes. So what would that mean? All we need to do is provide a point. I don't know, call it the origin, and...
Basically, we get to just pretend that it's like a single point on a line with a VC dimension of 1, and the same argument we had before applies.
Oh, that's a good way to say it. Just, you know, just think about the x-axis itself, and we can label something. Well, actually, it's simpler in a sense because we can keep the line steady, and we can just flip which side is, you know, by negating all the weights, we can flip which side is positive and which side is negative, and that gives us the two labelings of that point.
Right. And make a similar argument for a VC of 2.
So if the two points were on a line, then to do the four different combinations, we could...
So right, by putting that line to the left, we can label both of them positive. That's easy. Or we could label both of them negative by flipping the weights. Now we have to do the other two cases where they have different labels. So I'm going to recommend putting a blue line between them.
It's a thin blue line.
Yes. And, you know, the one on the right is positive, the one on the left is negative, or we can flip the weights and then flip the signs.
Yes, and 3 is where we got into trouble last time. So let's let me start off by giving us ourselves a clean slate. So this ran us into trouble in the case of the intervals because we couldn't do that case. And it looks like we're kind of hosed again, right?
Yeah, we are. We're actually completely hosed again if we do this. So I'm going to say that the problem is not with the hypothesis space. The problem is with the hand that is drawing points on the screen. So that's you. So here's the...
My hand is really depressed.
Well, I'm going to make your hand happier. So I think it's right that you can't separate this. It is, and the reason you can't separate it is because we have 3 points on the number line, and there's just sort of nothing to do here, just like we had before. But we are not restricted to the number line. So I'm going to recommend cheating and moving that point in the middle off the number line. So make a triangle. Stick it up in the middle somewhere.
All right, and that gives us the ability to handle this case now because we can just send our slicey line this way, put everything below it as positive, everything above it as negative.
Right. Now, of course, we still, by doing that, we might have messed up the other labeling, so we should check to make certain that we haven't screwed anything up. So we can make the top minus and the bottom plus. That's true. And we just by flipping the weights, we can make it the top plus and the bottom minus, right? So that's good. And then the question is, can we do everything else? Yeah, I think it's pretty clear, right? We can definitely label them all positive or all negative just by putting a vertical line somewhere off to the left.
Yeah, and I think it's actually easier than this because if you just think about vertical lines, then we really are back in the one-dimensional case.
Right.
And we handled the other 7 cases in the one-dimensional case really easily. It was just this extra case that we didn't know how to do, and now we do. We just use that third dimension, or the second dimension, even better.
Fair enough. Okay, so the answer is yes. I feel good about that. Okay, so that's good. So we got 1, 2, and 3 out of the way. So we know it's more powerful. We know that it's better. This is kind of nice. So now the question is 4. So thinking about it, I think the answer is no.
That would be nice, wouldn't it? But no, we need a slightly better argument, and I think we can do that. What we need. Again, what would be helpful is if we had an example where we could say, okay, here's a labeling that no matter how you lay out the points, you're going to fail.
So in order for that to work, we need to try to use all the power of the two dimensions so we don't fall in a trap, right, of like we almost did with VC3 by making them collinear. So why don't you place 4 points in the plane and make a kind of like a diamond shape or square, which is like
a
diamond.
It's a diamond shape if you, tilt your head a little bit.
Okay, so I'm going to tilt my head and look at it. So here's my argument. Now, I don't know if this is quite right, Michael, so help me out with it. The reason I don't think you can do 4 is because we've only got lines to work with, okay? So if you connect all the points, all pairs of points the way they, all ways they can be connected, so, you know, draw the square on the outside and then draw the two cross ones in the middle. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes sense, but I'm not sure where we're going with this.
Okay, so I'm not either. So work with me. So that's kind of all the boundaries that you can imagine drawing. And the problem that I see here is that because of the way that the two lines, the X in the interior of the square is set up, there's kind of no way to label the ones on the other side of those lines differently without crossing them. So that made no sense what I said, right? So try putting a plus in the upper left and bottom right and minus for the other two. So if you look at the two ones that are connected by the line with the plus and the two ones that are connected by a line with the minus, they cross each other, right? There's no way to put a single line that will allow you to separate out the pluses from the minuses here.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So in particular, anything that puts these two pluses on the same side is going to either put one minus or the other minus on that same side.
Right.
It has a very XOR kind of feel to it, to me.
Yeah, it does. It does. And in fact, it has an X right there in the middle.
It does. No, but that is true. But I meant it in a slightly different way, which is if you think about these four points as actually being, you know, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, and 1, 0, mm-hmm. then the labeling here is exactly XOR. And XOR is one of these things that you can't capture with a linear separator. So I think you got it.
No, that makes sense. So, and I think the important thing here is that, I like the XOR argument. The important thing here is that no matter where I move those four points, I can take the one closer or one farther away, and they're no longer squares, but they're whatever I want to be. You're always going to have a structure where you can draw those kind of crosses between the four points, or you're going to end up collapsing the points on top of one another or making three of them collinear or all four of them collinear. And so that makes it even harder to do any kind of separation because now we're back.
Right, so you fail on all of those. But there is one case that I'm not sure that you quite described yet, like that.
Right. Well, I think that works out to be the same thing, right? If you draw the connecting lines together, they're all going to cross at the middle point.
There's no crossings.
They all cross at that point. They
all
meet at that
point. They cross at that point.
They do. Well, so those are line segments, but those are just segments. They represent lines that go on forever.
Ah, good point. Yeah, so but the way that I would see this one is, again, just to give an example of a labeling that just can't be separated would be this one. Like, if you capture the outside points, assigning all the outside points one label, you can't assign the inside point a different label. It's inside the convex hull. It's going to have the same label as the other ones.
Exactly. So in my head, the main issue is when lines cross, there's really nothing you can do with a single line. Never cross the streams.
Yeah, it still doesn't feel like quite the same. I mean, maybe we're belaboring this point. Here in this square, if you actually let this corner point pushed into the middle, then we can linearly separate them.
Sure.
So I feel like these are two different cases. But
maybe.
Regardless, the point is that what we argued is no matter how you lay out the points, there's always going to be a labeling that can't be achieved in the hypothesis class.
Right. Yeah, the whole crossing of the lines thing really is about being able to get all four points. It's not saying that any pair of points works out okay. So what you end up doing is taking one of those points and dragging them into the middle, and then the lines all meet like in what you've drawn, and you end up with basically the same argument. I think it's the same thing. But I do agree with one thing, Michael, which is that we are belaboring this point.
Because the good news, or the exciting news, is no, we really argued that the VC dimension of linear separators is not greater than or equal to 4. So therefore, it's 3, because 3 works and 4 doesn't.
And 3 is my favorite number. So I have a question for you, Michael. I noticed that we keep getting, in all the examples we've done so far, we keep getting one more VC dimension. So does this kind of argument work if I went from planes to, or let's say, 2D space to 3D space? Or 4D space, or 5D space, if VC dimension is still 3, or does it keep getting bigger?